Mr. Knightley. Mr. Knightley. I stopped you ungraciously just now and gave you pain. If you have any wish to speak to me openly about anything you might have in contemplation as your friend, I cannot refuse you. Indeed, as your old friend, I will hear whatever it is you wish to tell me.
Emma, you want our friendship to remain the same as it has always been. But I cannot desire that.
But why? I know I made mistakes, but had you been here the last few days, you would have seen how I have tried to change. Please, tell me I am your friend.
I do not wish to call you my friend, because I hope to call you something infinitely more dear. Have you not wondered why I never befriended Frank Churchill? It was because I knew he was intended for you. Indeed, when you insulted Miss Bates at the picnic, I thought that evidence of his influence over you. And I could not bear to see it. So I went away. But I went to the wrong place. My brother's house is usually a place of comfort to me, but seeing your sister there kept you fresh in my mind. And the torture, I assure you, was acute. I only felt hope again when I heard of Mr. Churchill's engagement. And I rushed back, anxious for your feelings.